Couldn't care less about. I am the one and only Dr. Love, joined to my left by Mean Mean and to my right by Big Dog.
Once again, we'd like to thank all the chill bros for tuning in today and to all the chicks who found time to get out of the kitchen to listen to us. Mean Mean, how did our plans go last week?
Well, we only got to work on the lyrics for the Scallywag. We got the intro done and half of the first verse, so be expecting a preview this week or the following week.
Now for our news update.
First off, in China, an extremely rare donkey was born. As you guessed, this is the offspring of a zebra and a donkey. The foal, depicting the stripes of a zebra on parts of its body, was 3 feet tall at birth. According to the zoo staff, the zebra mated naturally with the donkey after being left free to roam together along with sheep in the same enclosure. Other names for this mix include Donkra, Zebonky, Zebrini, Zebrula, Zebrass, and Zedonk. Now I'm going to swing it over to Big Dog.
Thanks, Mean Mean. In Phoenix, Arizona, officials are considering turning dog waste into a green energy source. Students at the local Arizona State University are designing the dog waste digester, which will release the methane gas. Dog owners will put the waste into a biodegradable bag, place the bag into a digester, and then turn the crank that will start the process of releasing the gas. The methane will then be used on running street lamps first, and possibly more in the future. That's disgusting. Over to you, Dr. Love.
Thanks, Big Dog. In New Jersey, single mom Donna Simpson, who weighs a whopping 700 pounds, is making a career out of eating. She claims she makes $100,000 a year from her website where users can pay subscriptions to watch her eat. She plans to gain 300 additional pounds to become the most obese woman in the world. She already holds the Guinness World Record for heaviest woman to give birth. Donna admits she couldn't have done it without her 4-year-old daughter helping her shop and prepare her food. She continues to suffer from diabetes, high blood pressure, and heart disease. No way. Back to Mean Mean.
Guestnet has this new segment called Blank of the Week. I'll start it off with the movie of the week, Austin Powers Goldmember. The drink of the week, Fizzy Bubbly, sold at your local Walmart. Big Dog!
Thanks, Mean Mean. The shoe of the week, Vans. If you don't have any, you're stupid!
Stupid!
And the song of the week is Hero by Enrique Iglesias.
Let me be your hero. Would you dance if I asked you to dance? Would you run and never look back? Would you cry if you saw me crying? And would you save my soul tonight? Would you tremble?
That was beautiful. Dr. Love?
Thank you, Big Dog. That was truly an inspiring performance by Mean Mean. Now for this week's video game of the week, it's obviously COD. Yeah, and our team of the week is the Saskatchewan Roughriders. As you guys know, are part of the Canadian Football League. They will be taking on the Hamilton Tigercats July 16th at 4 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, so be sure and tune into that. And now back to the studio with this week's discussion topic.
The discussion topic this week is the Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2 premiere, which will be this Thursday at midnight.
As I'm sure you all know, this will be the last movie in this series, and we'll finish the tale of the famous Harry Potter.
Part
Part 1 ended after Voldemort stole the Elder Wand from Dumbledore's grave, and Part 2 will show Harry, Ron, and Hermione continuing their search for the remaining Horcruxes and Deathly Hallows until it ends with the Battle of Hogwarts.
Now, if you haven't read the 7th book along with the series, I suggest you do that before watching the movie, because the books have so much more vital information you have to know.
We obviously already have our tickets, and we suggest you see it in 2D the first time.
Because we are.
We'll be right back after this short commercial break from our sponsors.
Welcome back, everybody. The chill's comment this week was, my mother said she needed to talk to me about something. I told her, you already know what I want on my sandwich.
And the quote of the week is, don't get your knickers in a bunch, you pimple monkey.
And as always, I will leave you with the word of the week. Intrude. To interpose without invitation, fitness, or leave. Thank you for joining us for another Guess Your Dead shoutout. See you next week.